Hey guys, welcome back this week on Game Tech Radio News. The most hot topic of this week, PS5 Showcase reveals more details about their first party games, PS5 pricing, availability, pre-order date and more. Sony CEO says 99% of the PS4 games can be played on PS5. Earlier this week, PS5 pre-order went live ahead of the schedule. Unfortunately, Amazon customers may not get the PS5 on launch day. The standard PS5 will cost $499, while the digital version costs $399. The Xbox Series X comes in at the same price as PS5, and its digital option comes for $299. PS5 is launching on November 12 for US, Japan, Canada, Mexico, Australia, New Zealand, and South Korea. But the rest of the world will get it on 19th November. More gameplay footages of games were revealed. Check those on our Facebook page. Are you pre-ordering PS5 or Xbox Series X? Will you guys get a hand on? Let us know in the comment below. The Oculus Quest is an all-in-one headset without need of a PC. It is set to launch on October 13th, starting at $299. For eye, it comes with a resolution of 1832x1920 per eye. The Quest 2's touch controller also got a slight redesign for much better ergonomics. The Quest 2 still can connect to a PC via Oculus Link cable to play more intense VR games. So what do you think about the new VR in town? Cyberpunk Night City Episode 3 was aired this week, showing two trailers, one existing the postcards from the Night City, and the second one shows the types of gangs in the game. Big news for the PC gamers, the reveal of PC system requirements. If you haven't seen them, it's quite light and SSD is recommended. The game size is around 70 GB. The postcards from the Night City video shows more of scene setup. It's a grand playground for the wealthy, but underneath it's ugly. At the end of the video, they mention Night City Love, which is real website features or historical information about Night City, details on the district and more. The gangs of the Night City video showcases some of the street level factions you'll encounter in the game, including the augmentation obsessed Maelstrom, the gun crazy 6th Street, and the Wraiths and Eldicados who do the business in the Badlands. Apple unveils a lot of products this week. Apple Watch Series 6, Apple Watch SE, iPad Air, iPad 8 generation, and services like Apple One and Fitness Plus. Apple Watch Series 6 is the next iteration of Series 5, whereas SE is a budget-friendly Apple Watch priced around $279. The new 8th generation 10.2-inch tablet comes with A12 chip. It promises 3 times faster than Android tablet. The new iPad Air powered with A14 Bionic chipset. It comes with Touch ID inside the power button. iPad Air available in 5 colors. Apple One is one stop for all Apple services under one plan. It comes into 3 categories. Individual for $14.95, Family for $19.95, and Premium for $29.95. For all PS4 users, Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War Multiplayer Alpha is free from September 18th to 20. The Alpha contains the classic modes for 6v6 play, Deathmatch, Kill Command, and Domination. These modes will give you a rough idea of how the co-op multiplayer combat works. Stay tuned on our Facebook page for the live stream. Freebies and deals. Epic Store offering 3 free games, Football Manager 2020, Stick It to the Man, and Watch Dogs 2 this week until September 24th. So any football fans and Watch Dogs fans, grab soon. On Steam, THQ Nordic Publisher Sale is live until September 21st. Games like Desperados 3, Destroy All Humans, Wreckfest, and more games are all in sale. Up to 90% discount over these games, so act fast. Humble Bundle offers huge bundle sale on their website. The Boys Comics Bundle, Super Simulation Bundle, Tropico Bundle, and more bundles are in sale right now. Over 12 bundles are there, so choose whichever perfect for you. And do stay with us on GameTech Radar for latest updates.